निर्वासनस्फूर्तिमात्रो न किञ्चिदिव शाम्यति आफ्टर हैविंग शोन द नेसेसिटी ऑफ विड्रॉल फ्रॉम द कर्मस सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज द नॉलेज And what is the disposition of a jnani? Was told that jnani is the one who is abrahma stamba paryantam aham eveti nischayi. So one who has got that direct cognition that beginning from the embodiment of Brahmaji Hiranyagarbha up to any insignificant creature in the world. Nothing but Atma Swarupa, that Sarvatma Bhava is directly cognized by that person. Also he is Nirvasanaha Sphurti Matraha. Nirvasanaha. Where do the vasanas abide? Antakara. Now, do they abide in Atma? Atma is always Sphurti Matra. Why? Asanga. Because it is Asanga. So there, but the cognition of that because of the antakarana vasanas is not true to its nature. Therefore, that antakarana is made ready to cognize. See, even when the knowledge is gained, temporarily at that time, there are no visheshas. Otherwise, what will happen? The cognition is not true to its nature. But here, for continuous appreciation, by repeated nididhyasana, all these samskaras in the antakarana are nullified and therefore that antakarana is now nirvasanaha, nivrittavasanaha and therefore spurti matraha, kevala chidrupaha, that kevala chidrupa is now his cognition. Otherwise always, atma is always kevala chidrupa. Atma has never become samsari or nothing like that. So always Kevala Chidrupa, but here his appreciation, cognition is now Kevala Chidrupa because Antakarna has become so ready. And such a person, Nakinchi Diva Shamyati. So he gets absorbed in his Swarupa without being engaged in any specific Vyavaharas. Without being engaged in any specific Vyavahara, he just gets absorbed in his Swarupa. This is what the description of a jnani with the state of jnana with the disposition was given by the guru. Now the shishya comes out and he confirms, yes, yes, it is so only. Before you could say, I have already withdrawn from all these vyaparas. So therefore, karma with the tadadhyapi upa karma tadadhyapi uparamyatam. Withdraw from the karma was told, but long back I have already done that. It is so. It is so. He confirms, and afterwards, what is the result of this state of having got the knowledge and also withdrawn from all these? The result also will be given in the next chapter. First, in the 12th chapter, evam eva. Evam eva means this is so. What he said is exactly so, which I have already discovered, and I am already like that only. And 13th chapter, the result of that such discovery and such abidance will be told. Kaya krutya saha purvam tato vagvistara saha.
Kaya krutya saha purvam tato vagvistara
saha. Atha chinta saha stasma deva mevahamasthitaha. अहम पूर्वम अपि पूर्वम अपि आल्सो हैड टू बी एडेड अहम पूर्वम एंड अपि कायकृत्या सह ततः वाग्विस्तरा सह अथ चिंता सह तस्मा एवं एव अहम् आस्थितः तस्मा एवं एव अहम् आस्थितः सो आई एम लाइक दिस अहम् पूर्वम् फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सो आई दैट मींस आई वाज और आई एम लाइक दिस कायाकृत्या सह असहः मींस इंटॉलरेंट ऑफ समथिंग वन इज इंटॉलरेंट ऑफ समथिंग इज डिटैच्ड और माइंड हैविंग कंप्लीटली टर्न्ड अवे फ्रॉम समथिंग असहः सो इट मींस इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से आई कांट टॉलरेट इट व्हाट आई कांट टॉलरेट अहम् पूर्वम् फ्रॉम फर्स्ट कायकृत्या सह I am intolerant of all the actions at the physical level. Generally, who is such person? who is intolerant of physical actions? Crazy person. Even if the food, if it is put in the mouth, you will be happy. I take from the hand and put in the mouth, right? So it is not lazy person. He has nothing to get from this and he knows that there lies the big shapers. So, they say the curve of, you know, below the normal and above the normal appear to be same it seems. in between is only normal people. Those who are below the normal and above the normal appear more or less same. So, like this. So, पूर्वम अपि इवन द बिगिनिंग इट्स फॉर पूर्वम कैन बी टेकन दिस वे इवन बिफोर यू कुड से दिस हू हैज टोल्ड हिम इवन बिफोर यू कुड से दिस वाज माय आई एम लाइक दैट ओनली कायकृत्या सह मींस आई कांट टॉलरेट मींस आई एम फ्री फ्रॉम देम और दे आर नॉट पॉसिबल इन मी कैन बी टेकन दैट वे इनटॉलरेंस हैज टू बी टेकन दिस वे I am free from all actions at the physical level or actions at physical level are not possible in me. Read that me. Not that some disease is there. Read that me. Action means actions don't take place just like that. There is a purpose. The desire is there. The desire itself is no matter why should I take actions? So therefore, I am totally free from these. They are not possible in me. Tataha, thereafter, or thereby also, Vagvistara sahaha. So Vagvistara means the karmas at oral level, vocal level, like japa, prayers, etc. So Vagvistara sahaha means I am intolerant of japa karma etc. In a sense, I am totally free from them. Even japa, prayer etc. are not possible in me because I don't need them. I am totally grown out of them. Atha, here atha means ataha. So atha means not thereafter. Ataha, therefore, I am chinta sahaha. I am intolerant of chinta. Chinta here is मनोव्यापार रूपा चिंता नॉट अवर चिंता अवर चिंता इज वॉट यो मुसीबत वॉट टू डू एंड ऑल दैट नो नॉट दैट सो हियर चिंता इज मनोव्यापार रूपा मीन्स उपासना चिंता स्टैंड फॉर हियर उपासना सो देयरफॉर चिंता सह सो मीन्स आई इंटॉलरेंट ऑफ उपासना इन द सेंस आई एम फ्री फ्रॉम देम मीन्स दे आर नॉट पॉसिबल इन मी व्हाई नॉट पॉसिबल उपासना इज रिक्वायर्ड If I have to take to Upasana, who I should be? I must be Upasaka. And there must be Upasya different from me. Therefore, not possible. Why? Everything is what? Me only. Therefore, this, that means, division is just not possible. So, Chinta Saha. That is, I'm intolerant of this means, they are just not possible me, therefore, asma, aham is there already, aham, eva meva arsiraha, I remain like this only. What is remain like this? See, eva meva in that context has got different meaning because he is describing the different facets of one's own on account of this knowledge and not taking to any of the means. So eva meva, here eva meva means, see, what he has spoken is the activities at the physical level, vocal level and mental level. So vyapara, activities, what is it? Kaya kritya means vyapara, activity at physical level, bhavistara, activity at the vocal level, chinta, activity vyapara at the mental level. So now, I am like this means, it means, aham eva meva means nirvyaparaha eva astitaha. And without any vyapara, at all of these three levels, body, speech and mind, because I don't need them, I have totally grown out of them, the means that they can, that means, these are the means and the goals which they can serve, the means I have already accomplished, I don't need, I am free from them. I don't need the advice that from karma I have to withdraw, etc., I don't need. Okay. Why have you withdrawn or why don't you take to these means? Maybe you are a very, you must be, what is that? Shiromani among lazy fellows, huh? Topmost among the lazy fellows. Maybe so. No, this is the reason. Why have you withdrawn from them? About they don't need, I don't need them or they are not possible in me because Pritya bhavena shabdade ralishyadvena chatma.
Pritya bhavena shabdade ralishyadvena chatma.
Vikshe paikaka rudaya eva meva hamastitaha.
Vikshe paikaka rudaya
eva meva hamastitaha. Pritya bhavena. Armanaha cha adrushyatvena vikshepaikagra hrudayaha aham evam eva asthita vikshepaikagra hrudayaha aham evam eva asthita. Now, what he has put on here? Least interested in the actions vyapara at the physical, vocal and mental level. Now first he says, why he is not interested in actions at the physical and vocal level? Shabdade pritya bhavena. So, shabdadi. So, if shabdadi stands for not shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha, no, that is not the meaning here. Shabdadi stands here for shabda for the vyapara at the vocal level, speech level, that's prayers or man japa, loud japa, not manaska japa, loud japa, such things. Adi for the utaya vyapara, the activities, karmas at the physical body level. This is shabda adehe pritya bhavena, means in these, so with respect to the karmas at the physical and the vocal level, I have no preeti at all. Means I have no hankering, I have no fascination for them. When will we have fascination or that love? Means the necessity of them. When you are interested in the result thereof. So when you are interested in the result thereof, you will have the interest. That means you will be wanting to take to physical activities or the vocal activities. This is, I have no preeti. Why you have no preeti? Because what I can get out of this precious little, I know very well. That's what says, Krishnu phala janaka se shabda adi. So, these activities, they can give some phala, but what type of phala? Krishnu. Krishnu means that which is transitory in nature, impermanent in nature, which is going to get destroyed very soon, is not going to last forever. So that I am least bothered about them, I don't have any inclination toward them. Priti abhava means I don't have inclination, right? The result that they can give are precious little, I don't want them at all. So therefore, I am not interested in the shah, that is, physical actions and vocal actions. Fine, at least you should do upasana. If you don't want to take upasana, at least atma chintana you should do or not. Minimum atma chintana, why not? Is it, which atma chintana you are talking? Is it, look, these are the basis of getting misguided. So he says, atma chintana, which atma, come on. Atmana, see, if I have to do chintana of atma, atma must be chintyaha. It means fit to be thought of, is it? If I have to meditate on atma, atma must be an object of meditation. Means it has to be a, if I have to do dhyana of atma, atma has to be deya. It has deya. Who told you atma is deya? Is atma deya? Atma deya. Deya means what? It has to be an object of dhyana. And how dhyana takes place? In terms of antakarana vritti of deya. If atma, that means, if atma has to be an object of antakarana vritti, means atma has to be an object, which is not possible, because atma is very subject because of your antakarana is capable of functioning. So therefore is it, atmanaha cha adrishyatvena. Adrishyatvena means not being the dheya of dhyana, not being an object of dhyana. So that because of that, adrishyatvena, so I am not at all interested in chintana, manovyapara, chintana. I don't want it, no, just not possible. There is a question of me being interested, just not possible. So, acha, then why this shastra says, atmavare drashtavyaha, shrotavyaha, mantavyaha, nidibhyasitavyaha, and who has told this? None other than Yajnavalkya, Brihadaranyaka, this is from Brihadaranyaka, Yajnavalkya, is he wrong? See, that means, here is a student who has crossed that stage. This is what I want to impress upon. Otherwise, just literally you take and blast, this is wrong, that is wrong, and this then, and pose yourself with someone great, etc., is not going to help at all. So therefore, first assess, I should assess, where do I stand as a sadhaka? That's very important. So, what actually Ashtavakra Gita is, having gained the sadhya's goal, you need not continue with the means. That's what is meant. Therefore, many things are blasted here. For that, see. But unless the person has reached the goal, you blast it, what will happen? Therefore, that means you should understand in what spirit, in what context these statements have been made. So therefore, say, now, do you know who am I? So you may say, then why Shastra say like this, iti dhyasatavya, dhyana, upasana, all Upanishads and Smritis are full of upasana, etc. Why? They are meant for certain type of people. Do you know who am I? I am like this. I don't need them at all. Who are you? Vikshepaikagra hridayaha. This is very important. It shows his status, his eligibility. What means what level of maturity this person has got, who is now this shishya, who is declaring all these things. If you don't take into account, then just take literally and act, then it is a misleading. So therefore, I am the one who is vikshepaikagra hridayaha. Who is that vikshepaikagra hridayaha? Means my hridaya. Hridaya here is antakarna. My hridaya is the one from whom all the trivida vikshepa are already eliminated. In my antakarna, three types of vikshepa means adhyatmika, adhidaivika, adi bhautika, these vikshepas, these agitations cannot be there at all. Who can be such person? Means who has already in the past taken to all these means and has got such a ready frame of mind. So that is very important. I am such a person. Vikshepaikagradayaha. So that means if you want you can take this. Trividha vikshepebhyaha vyavruttam ekagram hridayam yasya saha. I am this type of person. With that, the one trividha vikshepebhyaha, from the three types of vikshepas, means tapatrayas. Tapatrayas giving rise to vikshepa agitations in the mind. So therefore, from those vyavruttam, that means freed from, these are eliminated from where? Ekagram hridayam, the hridayam antakarna, which is ekagra, means steady, single pointed, freed from all these tapatrayas and the resultant resultant agitations that they can cast in our bosom, that is antakarna. So the hridayam, the yasya saha, means one who has got such antakarna. Therefore, I don't take to any of these activities at physical, vocal or mental level. Therefore, evameva aham evameva asitaha. I remain like this. Here evameva means swasvarupena eva asitaha. I simply abide in my swarupa. I don't need any of this because my antakarna is vikshepaikagra hridayaha evameva asitaha. So these two stanzas go together. What was told in the first stanza, why is it so? The answer is given in the second stanza. So that is evameva. Evameva means here swasvarupena. See, in these all eight stanzas, not seven stanzas, evameva has to be taken, the meaning has to be taken in the context of what is told in that particular stanzas. So therefore, see, at the physical and vocal level, I am not interested in the karmas. Why? The result they can give, I am least bothered about it. Meditation level, Atma is not an object of meditation. And all these are required. For example, karma is required for a mumukshu to have antakarana shuddhi to take to karma yoga. I don't need, because my hridaya is what? Vikshepaikagra hridayaha. Even this oral level, therefore antakarana shuddhi. As for the results in terms of punya, I am not at all bothered. I don't want them, that much vairagya I have got. For antakarna shuddhi, I have already got it. Now if you say deha tadatme, and therefore atma chintana, dhidhyasana has to be taken to, where is the dhidhyasana? Because my antakarna is so pure that I can directly cognize my swarupa. Therefore eva meva means what? Swaswarupena eva asitaha. I abide in my swarupa. Okay, one may say, that is fine, you may not take to all this. At least you should take to means of getting samadhi or not. I think that much you should do. You should work for samadhi. Why one has to take to the means of gaining samadhi? Samadhi is the most misunderstood word. Generally our habit is, jump where? Ashtanga yoga. Yogastu chitta vritti nirodha. Yoga means, actually yoga means, that yoga word means samadhi only. See, is a sutra, the Patanjali sutra, like Brahma sutras. So that is atha yoga anushasanam. First on yoga anushasanam. Yoga. Then what is yoga? Yogastu chitta vritti nirodha. Yuj samadhav, one of the meaning of the word, verb yuj. Yuj samadhav. Therefore, samadhav means absorption of the mind. So therefrom that yoga means samadhi. योगा चित्त वृत्ति निरोधाय पद पातांजल सूत्र योगा मीन समाधि. सो नाउ दैट इज वन वे. बट द माइंड गेटिंग एब्सॉर्ब्ड इन स्वरूप ऑल्सो इज समाधि बट ज्ञान इज देयर. देयरफॉर से नाउ वट एवर इट मे बी विच एवर वे ऑफ समाधि वाई शुड वन टेक टू. Gaining nishtha in Atmajnana. Why have you no nishtha? So that means you have got Atmajnana. You have got Atmajnana and still no nishtha. Why? Why? What is the reason for that? Atmajnana is there, still Antakarna is the volcano. Means in Antakarna there are agitation. Even dhyana, what do you mean by dhyana? There are vikshepas in the even dhyana, because vikshepa in the antakarna is there. This is a way of pacifying the vikshepa you take to means of dhyana. Is it not? Likewise, dhyana stretched, nididhyasana stretched further, in its result becomes the leads, not becomes, leads to samadhi. So therefore, now samadhi is for whom? A practice of samadhi is for the one who has got the vikshepa in the antakarna. Even after gaining the Atmajnana, because of earlier habit, still what is that? Antakarna is still in a state of flux. So therefore the person has to take to Nididhyasana, which leads to Samadhi. We can take in the Jnana side. Otherwise there in the Patanjala, because the mind is agitated, you see. That's why you say, Patanjala Yoga is called as Chitta Chikitsaka Shastra. That very beautiful word it is. It appropriately tells. You know what is chikitsa? Treatment. Chikitsa, you know? Nursing homes and hospital chikitsa. That do the dispensaries are what? They give chikitsa means medical treatment. So chikitsa. Now, this is all sharirika chikitsa for the physical body treatment. But for mental treatment. Mental treatment means not psychic cases, okay? That is different variety. They have to be sent elsewhere. Okay. No, that was chikitsa only. That is not chikitsa. But here, chitta chikitsaka shastra. Chitta chikitsaka shastra means the mind is all restless, etc. How it can be made steady, calm, composed, non-reactive? The Ashtanga Yoga is the means. One of the means. No, don't say the Ashtanga Yoga is the only means, you can't say. If a person has got bhakti, and the bhakti is intense, same absorption of the mind which Ashtanga Yoga can give, this person can command. Karma Yoga, also with right attitude of Ishvara Arpan Buddhi can bring certain composure of the mind. There are many means, but Ashtanga Yoga is one of them. Even in that case also, why that person has to take the practice of Ashtanga Yoga? Because mind is agitated, vikshipta, is it not? So therefore, he says, Samadhi, in either way you take, whether after gaining knowledge also, if you practice for Samadhi or otherwise also, it is because your mind is full of so many superimposed things, which are the visheshas. And therefore, that mind has to be pacified for certain purpose, so that you take to the means of Samadhi. That's why he says, what is that reason, when, how it is not applicable to me, let us see. समाध्यासादि विक्षिप्तौ व्यवहार समाधये एवं विलोक्य नियममेवमेवाहमास्थितः. समाध्यासादि विक्षिप्तौ व्यवहारः समाधये एवं विलोक्य एवं नियमं विलोक्य. सी दैट नियमं, दैट लास्ट फ्रेज, संधि ब्रेकिंग इज लाइक दिस. नियमं एवं एव अहम् आस्थितः. before that I would like to ask, anyone can break this samadhyasadi vikshiptau? Samadhi asadi vikshipta. Is it not? That's exactly what I wanted. There is no samadhi. Because afterwards samadhi word is coming, you say, you will get trapped there. There is no samadhi then. See, actually, it's a prefix. See, sam, samadhyasa it will become. Ah is there. Sam, there are two prefixes. See, adhyasani. Actually, the word is adhyasani, which has got two prefixes. Sam plus a. Sam plus a plus adhyasani samadhyasi. I know that everyone will make it. Samadhi. I also did it, that's why. Sam plus a. We'll see what is the meaning, but note the prefixes. Sam plus a plus adhyasani. So adhyasadi vikshiptau means when the mind is vikshipta, agitated on account of adhyasa adi. Adhyasa means superimposition, wrong notions, wrong things which are not the true features of atma. Adi for its effect like desires, karma and all reactions, all those there. What is the sam a? Sam, you see, sam stands for sammak, thorough. A for asamanta, from all sides, nothing but full of these only, adhyasa only. When the antakarna is vikshipta, vikshipta agitated. So, why? Because of complete, that is all types of adhyasa. What is adhyasa? Superimpose. What type of superimposition? Superimposing the things which are not the features of Atma. All the features of Anatma. That sum stands for all varieties. Beginning from where? Ahankara onwards, gross body and afterwards. Because Vishaya, attachment to Vishaya, etc. That also can bring so many adhyasas. So, I am sukhi, dukhi, I am dejected, I am insulted, I am elated, I am honored. All varieties of this superimposition, thorough, asamanta from all quarters on account of all causes. So, that is, sammak asamanta adhyasadibhi vikshiptau. Adhyasa adibhi, by adhyasa, adi for its effect. The karma, karma phala, experiences, with all these, what is the state of mind now? Vikshipta. The mind is agitated. Somewhere. Samadhyasadi vikshiptau samadhaye vyavaharaha and bhavati. So, one has to take to the mean, vyavahara means here means samadhaye, for gaining the samadhi. Again, keep in mind, samadhi means absorption of mind in whatever that is dheya. So that's what is that. And in the case of Vedanta, the dheya is Atma Brahma. So therefore, for absorption, the mind is Atma Brahma. The means have to be taken. But evam niyamam vilokya, having known, observed this rule. What is the rule? Antakarna is vikshipta on account of all these reasons. Take to the means of practicing samadhi. This is the rule. Of vilokya, having observed that, having known this, he says, aham eva meva aham eva meva asitaha. I don't bother to take to the means of samadhi. I am what? Samadhi shunyaha eva. Evam eva here stands for samadhi shunyaha eva. Why samadhi shunyaha? Now go back to the second line of the second stanza. Who am I? What is my disposition? Vikshepaikagrahadaya. I am the one vikshepaikagrahadaya. Therefore, what is that? Vikshepa on account of samadhyasani are not in my antakarana. When they are not there, see, when do you take medicine? When disease is there. When disease is not there, only because medicine is sweet. Homeopathy pills, you know. So you don't go out taking them. So that's fine. So therefore, has nothing to do with means of samadhi. Therefore, see the status of the student. That doesn't mean otherwise what will happen. See, look here. Vididhyasana is the means for samadhi. Otherwise, Brahadaranyaka statement will go wrong. But for whom it is said? One who has got vikshiptantakarana. So for he has to take to that. So if that is not there, there is no need of that. So there, if the antakarana is not vikshepaikagrahadaya, and if you take that ashtakra, he has said that what? I don't take to means of samadhi means, then don't bother about samadhi. But at least you should be concerned about the nididhyasana, because that is where you can start. So if nididhyasana is discarded, what will happen? Ubhayabhrashtaha. The fellow will be ubhayabhrashtaha. Therefore, they will see the context. So that is evameva samadhi shunya. Why samadhi shunya? Because already, now take back here. Last stanza of earlier story. Nirvasanaha sphurti matraha eva. Because I never lose sight of the cognition of my true nature, where the question of any samadhi, etc. Because again, samadhi is a state for whom? Atma or anyone else? Samadhi is for whom? Atma. Antakarana, it is a state for antakarana, because you are antakarana is vikshipta, that has to be made absorbed in the dheya. Therefore, here I have nothing like that, because my mind never loses sight of Atma Swarupa, which is free from all these things. So I don't take to the means, because I am samadhi shunyaha itself. So I don't take to any means of samadhi. Then, further, I am free from harsha and vishada. Elation and dejection, I don't know at all what they are. Somebody told me, say, not nowadays, olden days. A judge, you know, a judge, he was told something about the bribe. He said, what is bribe? A judge, what is bribe? He doesn't know, because in those days were not there, but it was at least. Nowadays, you know, that's the thing, you see. It starts from top only. So therefore, like this. So therefore, this person, what is Harsha Vishada, he will ask you. He doesn't know, because he is not away from his one Swarupa. Even Harsha Vishada also are not there in me. If I Heyo padeya viraha devam harsha vishadayo ho.
Heyo padeya viraha devam harsha vishadayo.
Abhavadatya he brahman eva meva hamasthitaha. And adhyara. Purnatma darshinaha mama. Adhyara first. Purnatma darshinaha mama. Heyopadeya virahat. Heyopadeya virahat. Evam harsha vishadayoho abhavat. Evam harsha vishadayoho abhavat. He brahman अद्य अहम अद्य अहम एवं एव आस्थितः हर्ष विषादयोः अभावात् हे ब्रह्मन् अद्य अहम एवं एव आस्थितः पूर्णात्मदर्शिनः मम Who am I? I am the one who is Purnatma Darshi. So, earlier what was Sadhya Darshi was told. Means, this is what I want to gain. Such a darshana is not there in whom. Here it, he said, Purnatma Darshi means one has got direct cognition of Atma with nothing but limitless Ananda Swarupa. Purna means Ananta Ananda Swarupa, free from all limitations. So, पूर्णात्मदर्शन मम हेयोपादेय विरह विरह बिकॉज ऑफ एब्सेंस ऑफ हेय एंड उपादेय टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस फ्रेज प्रॉपरली यू कैन मेक एन अध्याय दैट हेयोपादेय वस्तुनः विरह विरह मीन्स सेपरेशन हियर सेपरेशन मीन्स एब्सेंस Because of absence of any vastus which can either be heya or upadeya. Heya means to be abandoned. Upadeya means to be acquired. Means from my standpoint, because who is me, keep in mind. Purnatma Darshinama, the one in whose cognition everything is nothing but Brahma and Brahma only, Sarvatma Bhava is there. And therefore, from that vision, there is nothing other than Atma. And because there is nothing other than Atma, so Heya Upadeya, Heya means Tyajya, to be given up. Upadeya means Grahya, to be acquired. What are these things? In life, what is that you would like to acquire and what is that you would like to reject or get rid of? Something other than myself, is it not? Something other than myself. Now to acquire or reject something other than myself must be there. But in my vision, there is nothing like that. Why? Purnatma Darshi, the one who has got Sarvatma Bhava. So therefore, Heyopadeya Vastunaha Viraha. Because such Vastu, a thing which can either be acquired or rejected or got rid of, such Vastu being not there, that means Evam. And because of that, Evam means in this manner, this in this way. In this way means because Heya and Upadeya are not there, but me and me alone is there. In this manner, Harsha Vishadayoho Abhava. In me, there is no possibility of Harsha and Vishada. See, when you can rejoice something, Upadeya is acquired. Whatever you would like to have, you got. Oh, ha ha. And suppose, when something is tyajya, that is heya, heya comes to you, what happens? Vishada, sorrow comes, remorse comes. So therefore, so in my case, both are not there. Why? Harsha, Vishada are with respect to our values to heya and upade. Our values in terms of heyatva and upadeyatva. From my vision, there is no Heya or Upadeya, therefore in me Harsha Vishada are not there. So therefore it says, He Brahman, Brahman here means He Guru, he addresses Guru as Brahman, He Brahman, so He Guru, because Brahman also means Brahmana, a Brahmana Shrestha, so He Brahman, He Guru, Adya means right now, Me Aham, Me, Evam eva asitaha, I remain like this. What is this evam eva here? Harsha vishada rahitaha eva. Here I am free from harsha and vishada because they are not possible in the absence of any heya or upadeya. Why so? Because I am Purnatma Darshi. So I have no harsha vishada. Further. आश्रमानाश्रमं ध्यानं चित्त स्वीकृतवर्जनम् विकल्पं मम वीक्षैतैरेव मेवाहमास्थितः आश्रमानाश्रमं ध्यानं एड तथा तद्युक्तं तथा तद्युक्तं चित्त स्वीकृतवर्जनम् तथा तद्युक्तं चित्त स्वीकृतवर्जनम् देन टेक दैट संधि ब्रेकिंग वीक्षैतैरेवमेव वीक्ष एतैः एवम् एव अहम् आस्थितः दिस इज संधि ब्रेकिंग नाउ अन्वय एतैः मम विकल्पं वीक्ष एतैः मम विकल्पं वीक्ष अहम् एवम् एव आस्थितः अहम् एवम् एव आस्थितः आश्रमानाश्रमम् आश्रम एंड अनाश्रम व्हाट इज दिस आश्रम विच आश्रम नॉट एनी आश्रम दिस ऑल्सो आश्रम इज इट नॉट आश्रम और होटल आई टोल्ड यू नो इट्स लाइक वी हैड गिवन द नेम ऑल्सो व्हाट इज दैट नेम Girishringa Ashram. Once in the circular, Girishringa Ashram was put. I said, do it, remove that. Some new person will come and ask someone like, oh, Bableshwar, where is Girishringa Ashram? First I put it, Shringagiri Ashram. Then I said, no. Shringagiri means Shringiri. Shringagiri applies to Shringiri. So if I, Girishringa Ashram. So long as we are here, it is Girishringa Ashram. I think best ashram it is. So, but that is not the ashram here. So here ashrama means varnashrama. The four statuses in life. Brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyasa. But anashrama is there. So therefore it is not for three only. So here ashrama stands for, because anashrama word is there. So ashrama word stands for, that is brahmacharya, grahastha and vanaprastha. Then anashramam, that is for sannyasa. How? Because for sannyas also, sannyasi, it's called also atyashrami. Atyashrami means one who has crossed the ashramas, brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha. So anashramam or atyashramam is sannyasa. So therefore, otherwise sannyasa comes under ashrama, four ashramas it comes. So it's separately told here. So therefore, ashrama, anashramam means earlier three ashramas, brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha and sannyasa. Why that sannyasa is separate? Because slight difference. What is the difference? In the earlier three ashramas, karma upasanas are involved. Well, here, sannyasa, in principle it is not there. So karma is not at all there. That's why I say, if a person has no antakarna, see, sannyasa has to be taken only after having antakarna shuddhi. So, suppose by chance or mistake a person has, because after having taken sannyasa, the person is not eligible to take to karma. But without karma, antakarna shuddhi is not possible and this fellow has no antakarna shuddhi. So then what is to be done? So then, as a means given, some prayers, etc., upasana is given as an exceptional case is given to the sannyasi. So that means that person can have antakarna shuddhi. So the guru seva and such things can be given because karma the person cannot take to, sannyasi is not eligible. Like Rudra, Dhyayi, etc., you know, chanting of Rudra, the Vedic hymns, etc., Vishnu Sahasranama, and such things are permitted so that at least, because some lapse has already taken place, some mistake has been committed to set it right, certain few things are there, but no karma is not possible for him. So therefore, to distinguish between the earlier three and the last one, that is separately anashrama is put there. Ashrama, anashramam. So these are ashramas, earlier three and sannyasa. So also dhyanam. So dhyana, dhyana, meditation. Meditation. Meditation can be at both levels. It can be saguna brahma, upasana or nididhyasana, nirguna brahma, nididhyasana, dhyana. And on account of this, tatha tadyuktam. So also, that is now look here. How many things are there? Ashrama, anashrama, one thing. The status is in life, one thing. Then dhyana, that meditation or contemplation, nididhyasana. Then tatha, so also, tadyuktam, endowed with this, means connected to this ashramas, anashramas and dhyana. What are those? Chitta sri krita varjanam. Whatever that is to be accepted and rejected based on ashrama, anashrama and dhyana. On account of these two earlier, ashrama and ashrama is one and dhyana is other, certain things have to be taken to, accepted, certain things have to be rejected. A brahmachari has to lead a certain type of life. Grahastha, certain duties are to be discharged. Vanaprastha, an ascetic life has to be practiced. In this context, whatever that is against such thing have to be eliminated, discarded. All these rules are there. See? Now dhyana. So dhyana means what is to be done? You have to keep or maintain a specific type of vritti and eliminate rest of the vrittis. So there are certain rules are there. So therefore that is what is called as chitta svikrita varjanam. So that is what means these are the three things. See, we have to add that, you can break the sentence. Santi. So these three things are there. What are those? Ashramas, brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyasa. Then dhyana and related things like things to be accepted or taken to or to be avoided, rejected by mind on account of these three. So these three, santi, these three things are there. But I analyzed, I investigated this. So, and I found etaihi tribhi, tribhi. By these three, mama vikalpam viksha. By these three, what I can get is only vikalpa. Vikalpa means here, vikshepa. Even, see, look here the problem lies. Keep in mind, who is this person? One who has already given the credentials. What is it? He never loses sight of Swarupa. And one who has got vikshepa, vikshepaikagra, hrudayaha. So that's all that already told. Who doesn't need the even means of samadhis to, that means to get rid of this adhyastha, etc. and the vikshepa on account of that. Now you say, now if I take to this, so what happens? So, etaihi, even by these means which are otherwise indispensable, he says, etaihi tribhi, mama vikalpam viksha. Mama vikalpa means bheda in me. Vikalpa also means bheda. These cast bheda in me. Now come on, you start from ashrama. Whether brahmachari, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyasi, and whatever that is applicable to that, if I have to take to first, what I have to do? What I have to do? Take the body and I identify with the body. Identify with the body and do something which is different from me. So let us say, to invoke some deity or Ishwara or that may be different from who? Me. Vikalpa or nirvikalpa? Bheda or abheda? Bheda. Truth is, I have discovered that abheda, nirvikalpa, one and the same swarupa. Therefore, what I, I land in Veda because of that. Now we may say dhyana. Even nididhyasana. See, the culmination of nididhyasana may be absorption in the Advaya Swarupa Brahma. But to begin with, me, who is taking nididhyasana, who is that me? Come on, tell me. Let us say, one who has no identification, because he has got jnana, still he has to take nididhyasana. Why? You can take here. Vikshipta hridayaha. Antakarana is vikshipta. Therefore, before taking to nididhyasana or means of samadhi, what is the condition? I should be the one who is, whose mind is agitated. I don't have, I already told you, vikshepa ikagradaya means, if I have to take to nididhyasana or means to samadhi or dhyana, what is told here, so therefore what happens? Bheda, is it not me who is different and want to get absorbed in the swarupa? So again, I am first, what I am doing? I am first, that means imputing the bheda, that is what vikalpam. So, etaihi tribhi, by these three, that is four ashramas, jnana and acceptance and rejection on account of this means what is to be done. Chitta svikruta varjana means these do's and don'ts, you can put that way. Chitta svikruta varjana means the do's and don'ts on account of ashrama and the jnana. So by these three, mama vikalpam, my bheda in me, what is that me, mama? Advaya swarupa, me in me, bheda comes, viksha, having seen that, so what do? I don't take to such divisions, eva meva hamasthitaha, I am like this only, eva meva means here, eva meva, etatraya rahitaha, free from these three, what are those three? Four ashramas, jnana, and do's and don'ts on account of this. I am avikalpaha, I am nirvikalpaha. So for those who have got vikalpa, these are required, not for me. Therefore, I am free from them. So therefore, all these are given by the person who have already reached the highest goal, from whose vision there is nothing other than Atma, Purnatma Darshi, the person is, from that standpoint we are discarded. Without accomplishing that, if you blast this, then you are in for trouble. That is what we, what will happen? Why trouble? The only means available you discard, and what is it? Suppose there is a disease, and there is a specific remedy, you throw it, then what? Suffer, that's it. So you may give 1000 arguments and say that, but no, that means the goal is not reached. Further, about the karmas. Karmanushthanam ajnanat yathai oparamastatha. Buddhva samyagidam tattva meva meva hamasthitaha.
Buddhva samyagidam tattva meva meva hamasthitaha.
This guy, ye guru se bhi upar wala hai wo. Because guru had told what? In the, this 10th stanza, 10th chapter, last one. Karma, that is dukkha maya sadam karma tadadhyapi uparamyata. That is what karma is, dukkha maya sadam. Therefore what? Withdraw yourself from karma. You say taking to karma is on account of ignorance, and trying to withdraw from karma also is on account of ignorance only. I need not bother about both, you say. So I am least concerned about karma, nor withdrawal for karma, because both are products of ignorance only. So therefore, संधि ब्रेकिंग कर्मानुष्ठानम अज्ञानात् यथा एव उपरमः तथा नाउ टेक द अन्वय यथा एव कर्म कर्मानुष्ठानम अज्ञानात् यथा एव कर्मानुष्ठानम अज्ञानात् तथा एड एव परमः अपि परमः अपि मीन्स अज्ञानात् परमः अपि अज्ञानादेव इफ यू वांट यू कैन टेक दैट वे आल्सो परमः अपि अज्ञानात् एव इदं तत्त्वं सम्यक् बुद्ध्वा एवमेवाहमास्थितः इदं तत्त्वं सम्यक् बुद्ध्वा एवमेवाहमास्थितः सो यथा एव इन द मैनर दिस मैन व्हाट इज दिस मैनर कर्मानुष्ठानम् अज्ञानात् भवति performance of actions or means acting in the world vaidika or laukika karmas performing these on account of what karma is for karma phala karma phala for gaining something enjoying something gaining enjoying for what dukkha prapti If you have not it, after the others started laughing, why they laugh? Sukha prapti, dukkha nivritti. That I want to have sukha, I want to get away from dukkha itself is a blunder. It's a mistake. Do you know why? Because you don't know your swarupa. Your swarupa is nothing but ananda. Where is the question of meaning ananda? Your swarupa is not at all connected with sorrow, no trace of sorrow either, which sorrow you want to get rid of. That is the truth. But what is our present state, plight? We have no sukha, we have nothing but dukkha. How? Due to ignorance. Due to ignorance you have landed in a plight where you have no ananda at all, but what you have is nothing but sorrow. Therefore you want to get rid of sorrow and get happiness. So you want to take to karma. Karma is because of ajnana. Achha. Then let us give up karma. That also because of ajnana only. Why ajnana? Why you want to give up karma? Because Shastra says, if you take karma, karma phala will come. Karma phala means papa punya. Papa punya means punarjanma. Punjanma will come. For whom punarjanma? Atma is ajanma. He has no janma. He has no embodiment at all. Again, uparama also is for because of ajnana, due to ignorance. So, nor do I quote the karma, nor am I frightened of karma at all. That's what he says. I need not bother to perform a karma, nor need I run away from karma because karma can't do anything to me. I am free from both. So therefore he says, yatha eva karmanushthanam ajnana tatha eva in the same manner uparamaha. Uparamaha is karmoparamaha. Karmebhyaha uparamaha. The withdrawal, cessation from karma. Now you may ask, then why Shastra speaks of sannyasa? Why Shastra speaks of sannyasa? Karmoparama is given by whom? Shastra. So, then why? Because at that level, like restricted diet, it is required. But not the swarupatah. Swarupatah, that's what I say. Every statement of this Shishya has to be viewed from the level of his accomplishment. Don't bring out of the context, then you will be landing in trouble. Otherwise Shastra says, Vidhi Dhyasitavyaha, Sanyasya Shravanam Kuriya, Shastra maintained. Give up our karmas means rise above karmas and take to Shravana Manana Nididhyasana. Therefore, here is a student who has already crossed that stage, and from that level he is declaring. So that's what it means. Otherwise, what will happen? Sannyasa will be the highest goal of life. No, sannyasa is a means. That doesn't mean that those who have not taken sannyasa will not be able to gain the knowledge. Janaka was not sannyasi. But here he was a jnana-nishtha. So therefore, the means has to be cut to its own size and not to be turned as goal. So, therefore, uparamaha tatha idam tattvam samyak buddhva. Having known this principle very well, that both karma and cessation from karma, withdrawal from karma, both are products of ajnana. Whereas I don't have ignorance of myself, I can clearly appreciate what my swarupa is. So therefore, eva meva ahama sitaha. I am like this only. What is that eva meva? Karma taduparama rahitaha. Free from karma and also withdrawal from karma. I have nothing to do with both. Eva meva ahama sitaha.
स्वस्ति प्रजाभ्यः प्रतिपालयन्तां. Ooh.